Hello. Welcome to the live drawing party for Thursday, April 23rd. I'm Danny Gregory, and as you can see, it is horrible here. Horrible, people. I don't know. I was thinking about where I should go today, and I thought, you know what? I'm going to sit underneath this mulberry tree. This mulberry tree is constantly raining down mulberries on the ground. And every day I'm hosing them to get them out of the way. And birds are coming in and feasting on them. And it's a hellish mess. So I'm figuring it's possible that mulberries will be dropping on me today. It's not a problem I've ever experienced before. In New York City, I've never had a mulberry fall on me. But here in the hellhole that is Phoenix, Arizona, I have to battle the elements every day. Well, I'm super glad that you're here. I hope that it's not too awful where you are, or that it is actually wonderful in some way. That's probably more important. Yulia in Los Angeles, where it is sunny and hot. Yes, I think you guys are getting the same weather that we're getting, which is it's supposed to reach 100 degrees soon, which I'm fine with. I have no problem with scalding inferno heat. It's fine. It's cool. What else? Mulberry trees are illegal in El Paso. Now, there's a piece of trivia that I'm going to store and no doubt pull up at some point. Why? Because they're, I don't know why. I mean, you can make them into foods and stuff. Muffins, somebody's told me here. Anyway, what else? Who else is out there? Robin, who has made it despite the rain in northern Georgia. That's good to know. And Elena in Mexico, hola to you. Glad you could join us. So if you've never been here for a live drawing party before, it's fun. You've come to the right place. We're going to do some cool stuff. And it's not really a drawing lesson. It's just kind of, you might learn something. I usually do. But it's intended to just be a fun opportunity to get together and draw every day, because drawing every day keeps the psychiatrist away. I have not had a psychiatrist anywhere near me, at least in the last 4 weeks. But maybe you have, and maybe drawing will help you. Maybe you could draw with your shrink. God knows we could all use some shrinkage. Yes. Okay, so today, I wanted to prepare you, because we're going to draw from TV. We're not actually going to draw from TV. I'm going to show you a video, and we are going to draw from it. But it will be intended as kind of an exercise in how we can incorporate television viewing into our creative habit. I think we're all probably watching more TV than normal. I in some ways feel like I'm watching actually less TV than normal. I don't know. I feel like a lot of television kind of makes me feel uncomfortable these days. So we're watching a lot of things that are kind of benign. Cheers. We've been watching Bosch, which I always like, but you know, just think stuff that feels like not too high anxiety, to just kind of calm, not too psychological, not too demanding. But let's despite that, think about how we might use all this television that we're watching to help us to draw more, because we're probably distracting ourselves with the television that we're viewing. So why not use that distraction to our advantage? So if you have a sketchbook, if you have pens, pencils, whatever it is available to you, that would be good. That would be nice. I see more people checking in from Iowa, Mary in Michigan, Janice in Virginia. Let's see if I can find any more alliteration. Sezgi Uygur in Istanbul. I'm sorry, I mangled your name. Karine in Morocco. And Deb in sunny Brooklyn. Catherine in Aix-en-Provence, and Elizabeth in the Netherlands. So lots of people, lots of places, all of whom hopefully have television. So What else are some of you watching? Jennifer's watching Jeeves and Wooster. Good call. A little P.G. Woodhouse. You know, when I was younger, this will give you an indication of how enormously cool I was as a teenager. But when I was a teenager, I read all, I think it was 99 at that point, P.G. Woodhouse books. And never had a date. Allie is watching Red Dwarf. I've never seen it. It's, I gather, either a science fiction show or it's somehow about little communists. Not sure. Sounds interesting. I'll have to check it out. Ruth is daring and drawing political figures on television. Oh, God, that sounds awful. Not doing that. Karen's watching Cheers and Arrested Development. Good one. Arrested Development. Haven't watched in a long time. Becky's watching Dragnet and Batman. I like it. So, yes. So, good. So, we're watching TV. So, what I wanted to do is I'm going to play a film. It's a film that you may have seen. It's a film I made with my son, Jack. It's about our friend, Tommy Kane. I just wanted to have a piece of stuff that I own the copyright to, sort of. I'll probably get in trouble because there's some uncopyrighted music on it, and YouTube always complains about that, but I don't care. It has the right music on it for the show, for the film that it is. So I'm going to, here's what I want to do. I want to play the film for, you know, 30 seconds or so, and then randomly stop it. Okay. And when we stop it, I'll set a timer for a couple minutes and we'll draw whatever it is that happens to be on the frame, on the screen. Okay. So we just want to draw whatever's in that frame and do it quickly. And this is kind of a test because it's not a test exactly, but an experiment in how you can do this when you're watching television. So obviously it would be probably annoying if you're watching TV with other people and you keep stopping and starting the TV with the DVR remote, you know, you can do that. But often if you're watching commercial television, a commercial comes on, you don't really want to see it. That would be a time where you could pause it. You could say, hey guys, let's not watch the commercial. I'm just going to pause it, freeze frame, whatever it is. It might be the first scene of the commercial, anything that it is, and then just draw on it. What's nice about this exercise is it allows you to have really random subject matter appear before you. It could be a face. It could be a street scene. It could be interior of an apartment. It could be a car driving. It could be lots of different things we never know, but it just gets you going and go, okay, boom, I can just draw this. Again, it doesn't matter if it's good. Nobody needs lots of really good drawings of freeze frames from TV. That's not the point. The point is just exercising and getting it going, okay? So let us get ready to do that. And let me just get my iPad to cooperate. Again, I'm going to draw on the iPad because I'm under the mulberry tree. And this appears to be the appropriate medium for under mulberry tree. I have no idea what I'm talking about, honestly. So what we're going to do is, this will be a little bit of a jump back and forth, so bear with me because I'm trying to figure it out. Deb considers watching Big Bang Theory, MASH, or The West Wing. Could be. West Wing might be challenging. Evocations of Better Times, perhaps. MASH, maybe. It's about war and disaster and surgery in Korea. I don't know. That might be good. Big Bang Theory. Yeah, a lot of smart people. Maybe they could solve this problem for us. They're still around, right? As far as I know. Okay, here we go. 30 seconds, and then I'm going to pause it. Eventually, we'll watch the whole film. I think it's like 5 or 6 minutes. So we'll probably do this like 4, 5, 6 times. Let's see. Okay. Helen, I don't know what time you have in Iowa, but it is drawing from TV time. So get ready, and here we go. Hopefully you can hear me now. So this is a random frame that I have picked, and we're just going to quickly draw whatever we see on this frame. Let me see if I can actually introduce myself into this frame. Possibly not. Yes, I can. Okay. So I'm going to quickly draw Tom. This is my friend Tom Kane. I didn't actually explain that, did I? But yeah. And here we go with the timer. I forgot that. God, I'm juggling 10 different pieces of technology here. Hopefully you're just dealing with a pen. Okay, 2 minutes on the timer. Here we go. All right, I'm scrawling here because I'm nervous about the amount of time that I gave us, which is foolhardy, but yeah, it's going to be fast. It's going to be fast. Fast and Furious seems to be the thing that works to get your blood pumping and to get your drawing skills humping. Ah, that's it. That's the old timer. Okay, you guys ready to continue? Right, another rather random image, but let's try it out. So, I think you have to decide how much of this you're going to draw and what are you going to focus on. But there's 2 minutes to do it in, so let's be agile. It's that one bird that makes that weird, annoying sound. Yes, I hear you. I hear you. I know. That's it, folks. Alas, we are done. Okay. Oh my God. All right, here we go. We're going back. We're going to try this some more. Hope you're keeping up. Okay. This is a god-awful frame that I picked. I apologize in advance, but we can do it. We can do it if we can really try. I mean, maybe I should think about these frames before I pick them, but no, that wouldn't be right. This is about randomness. So, gotta live with serendipity, the vagaries of the universe. This drawing is meant to be because it appeared. Minutes on the clock. All I can say is I'm pretty sure Tom's not watching this, and thank God for that, because this would be humiliating if he saw me forging him on live YouTube. It is interesting, though, to do a line-by-line copy of the work of somebody who you admire, and I certainly admire Tom an enormous amount. This is not a drawing you're probably going to frame or add to your portfolio, I would imagine, because you have really unusual ambitions with your work. I guess that's one of the good things about this, right? I seem to be actually done with this earlier than I thought. Maybe it's because most of it is out of focus, but I apologize to you for having to endure this on your own. Okay. Okay, there we go. All right, that's, thank God, the time is up. Okay. Yes, good. Let's carry on and let's pray for a better scene next. All right, let's try this one. Let us give it a whirl. Yeah. There's some kinds of creatures biting me under the mulberry tree here. Don't bite under the mulberry tree. I like this t-shirt. Tom is way cooler than me, so I'm glad to have him as a friend. And I like Mr. Softy, but I don't have any t-shirts. You know, there seems to have been a truck in our neighborhood the last couple days that I think might be an ice cream truck. And what does it play? It plays some, it plays the theme from the, plays the theme from Andy Griffith Show. That's what it is. Every day it plays the theme from the Andy Griffith Show. Speaking of benign TV shows that one could watch, that would be a good one. So this is a little bit meta, doing a drawing of somebody doing a drawing, right? But promise you the next day. Alrighty. Alright, now, it would have been a better idea if I'd gotten, like, an image, a tape from, of, like, Mannix or something. Mannix, how did I come up with that? Mannix. Do you remember Mannix? I don't really either. I like the name of it, though. Alright, this is actually kind of bit of a pleasure to draw just because it has these very, very clear outlines, right? I mean, it's very clearly structured, so it's actually kind of a bit more reassuring. It's nice to paint things or draw things that are, you know, have a nice, clear, orderly structure. It's again in the category of what I would call almost crossword puzzle drawing, in the sense that You just need to do the one above and the one below, and eventually you will have the whole thing worked out. And there's no sort of like impossible strategy to figure out, like, oh my God, how do I draw this out of focus hand that's moving in the foreground? You know, this kind of drawing, it's like, nah, this is pretty straightforward. Just need to draw the bits. And so therefore, it's more relaxing somehow. I remember shooting this, actually, now that I think about it. I remember this day quite clearly. It was quite a nice day to be doing this with my son and my friend. Had a good time filming this. Various parts of Brooklyn. This took us a day to film it. Took a few more days for me to cut it, but I'm proud of it. It captures a moment in our lives that was nice, and yeah. Back in the day when you could draw in Red Hook. There we go. That's it. Time's up. Done. Okay. Okay, let's try this one. At least it has a car in it. Let's give it a whirl. Let's try it out. I'll put my little frame over here. Tuck it the other way. And set the timer. 2 minutes starting now. Go. Swing. Swinging into action. So Tom has a process that you may or may not have glean from this kind of staccato intermittent performance of this film. This film is actually a really good kind of capturing of his process. And what he does is he, or at least this was his process, it's changed a little bit over the years, but generally what he does is he draws with a uniball, actually, which is like a rollerball pen, and then when he's done with that, and then he does all this elaborate cross-hatching and stuff, then he colors the general kinds of overview colors, I would say, the kind of more generalized colors in watercolor, kind of finished watercolor. He builds it up a bit, but he a lot of it is like almost coloring with watercolor as opposed to actually trying to do, like, you know, fine watercolor wet on wet technique. He's adding color essentially using watercolor, and then you'll see next he then goes over the whole thing with colored pencils, and they add a lot of pizzazz, really. to this drawing. So, yeah. All right, time's up on this one again, I'm afraid. Let's try another moment. All right, I think I'm getting better. This is a better frame, don't you think? Better frame of, we can at least see a face here. So let's give it a whirl. See if we can draw it in the short time allotted, which is 2 minutes starting now. I never really noticed Tom's eyelashes before. Known the guy for 30 years. I find him incredibly difficult to draw. I've drawn at Tom many times over the years, and not under these conditions, of course, which makes it even worse. But yeah, he's got like very fertile eyelashes. I have to ask him about that sometimes. I'm not sure that he does anything with them. Not sure that it's yeah, this is really about his facial hair, but you know, I'd like to actually spend a lot more time doing this drawing, because it's kind of simple, the design of it is simple, but there's something about this frame that's quite good. Time's up, folks. We're moving on. Okay, hopefully we can accomplish this in 2 minutes. It's going to be tough. Go! All right, somebody here has mentioned all the drawings of Tom that are in Tom's book, and that actually was began as a sketchbook school project when a lot of people were drawing Tom when he taught in our very first class, which was called Beginning, and for some reason people love to do drawings of Tom, and so he ended up in a book that he did. There was a collection of all of his drawings. He included a page of all these drawings done by sketch. He had that, in fact, he built a website for people to submit. Just all these weird drawings, but they were all, I mean, there were amazing ones, there were weird ones, there were so many different kinds. It was great. It was a great idea. And it's a great book, too. Good God. All right, that's it. 2 minutes on the clock. Okay, let's go back to watching this. All right, another close-up. There. Let's go. Let's knock this thing out of the park, folks. This is, in a way, feels a little simpler, perhaps, because it is a series of kind of concentric lines and arcs. All right, 2 minutes. I really could only figure out the basic structure of that thing, and that confounded me, I have to say. I thought it was going to be pretty simple. It was not so simple. Okay, one more. I think this may be the last one. So let's make it really awesome. Here we go. We're going to suffuse this with awesomeness, and it will be our 10th and final attempt at doing this. Here we go. Fast, furious. Well, I'm not furious. Perfectly happy. Sitting here under the mulberry tree with you. And we are doing the best thing ever, which is to draw. But I am moving fast. Tom's house has an awful lot of stuff in it, as you can see. Tchotchkes galore. Lots and lots of beautiful artwork. And doodads and weird toys that he collects and all kinds of stuff. It's an interesting place to visit. Realize that one of my problems that I'm having with doing these drawings is that the proportions of my page are not the same as the proportions of the screen. And that can be problematic. Yeah. So you think that you're hugging the edges and you're not. You're really creating something awful. I mean, not awful, but you know what I mean, different. Okay, that's the time. Okay. Let's watch the rest of this in peace, shall we? And then you can see what actually Tom is making. I'm not sure what happened just then, but thanks for joining me. I think that, yes, some of you asked if there's a place that you could watch this whole film. There is. It's called Red Hook. It is, it's on my channel. Might be on the Sketchbook School film, Sketchbook School channel, but it's definitely on my channel on YouTube. It's called, it's one of several films that we made together. We made one about my friend Butch Belair. We made one about an animator, another one about a tattoo artist, and there's one of me drawing my breakfast. So yeah, so if you go to my thing, you'll see it. So listen, that was fun. I didn't really love the drawings. I don't know about you. I realize now in retrospect that film had a lot of similar kinds of structure setups. But if you can imagine when you're watching television, if you're watching commercials, like commercials have dozens of individual scenes and shots in them. So you might get very, very varied kinds of images. So it's really a great kind of exercise to move things along quickly. So here's what I would say. Try this out. I'd like to see if I think a good way of doing this is to have like a lot of little frames drawn on your page. You know what I mean? So you draw, maybe have a dozen or more little rectangles that are TV shaped drawn as like almost like a film strip across your page, and then just fill them in one after the other. So they're small. You're drawing them for a minute or two, and you can pack, you can really figure out the composition of each individual frame that way and figure out a shorthand for doing it. I should have demonstrated that better, but we'll do it again if you found it interesting, and maybe I'll find, maybe we could do like a film noir or something. I remember once Felix Scheinberger had a kind of an example like this, and I ended up doing, I think his suggestion was to use like a Sergio Leone spaghetti Western, because there's so many, like, it has that wide CinemaScope shape, and there's like really dramatic angles, and it was pretty cool. So that is, if you want to know anything about me, by the way, if there's some questions about that, my name is Danny Gregory. There's this, you can just go to Google and type it in. You'll probably get to my website or my something or other today. I don't know, I have a website, I have a blog. I have a company, it's called Sketchbook School. So, but I don't think I'm going to be out here under the mulberry tree again, because it seems like I'm being like the, anyway, tomorrow we're going to do something really interesting and bizarre and different. Potentially offensive? Not really. Only if you're easily offended. I don't think you'll be offended. We'll see. Maybe you will be. Interesting. I hope not to offend you. But I hope to, give you things to think about when it comes to doing drawing. So we'll meet again tomorrow. Same time, same place. It'll be Friday. And it'll be the end of the week, and we'll do some final drawings for the week, and then you can spend the weekend practicing, all right? So that was a good challenge. I'm proud of you for keeping up with it. I hope you'll try it on your own. And you know what? I'll put the link to Tommy's film in the description here below. So if you wonder about it, you can find it there. Okay, thanks very much, and I'll see you tomorrow.